So I recently started looking at the Papervision 3D rendering engine. It's a 3D engine for, the Swift player, the Flash player, which is open source. And I thought that I would cover the basics of, basically downloading the files that you need and setting up a project to start working with it. Not going to go too greatly into the code on how you use it right now. There might be some future videos on that as I learn it myself. However, I thought I would show you how you download and use it. I'm going to be using Flash Builder 4 on the Mac. The process is the same on Windows, and it's not that different for using, say, Flash Professional as well. I just like to use Flash Builder for writing my code. It's just something I prefer using over Flash Professional. So the first thing you need to do is go to the website, which is papervision3d.org. And it's kind of interesting actually, when you go to the website, it's going to do its little thing here, and it doesn't give you too much to work with, but it's actually downloading an example file for you, which is all very cool and looks nice, but it doesn't give you a way to, just leap in there until you know where the code is, and I'll show you in a second. But they have this nice little example here of what it can do. We have this underwater scene with this shark, and just bop him on the nose to make him swim away there. But to actually go get the code and all the relevant files, what you need to do is go up to this little logo in the corner here and just click on there, and it's going to bring up the blog.papervision3d.org. And if you go over on the right-hand side, you'll see as you look down, there's the project home here, so we're going to click on there to open that. And I'll just close these other tabs here. And so this is actually the home of the code that we need to get. It's hosted on Google, so it's code.google.com/p/papervision3d. And if we go over to the downloads tab here, really the only file that we need to get working with here, we don't need the source code or anything. We can actually use the compiled binary, the .swc or swc as it's pronounced file, which is a pre-compiled file for us, and we're just going to include that library in our projects. So we're just going to click on it here. And I'm going to click again to download. And that's going to put it in my downloads folder. Now, what you need to do is find somewhere safe to put that on your machine, because you're going to need to reference that over and over again each time you create a project. So what I'm going to do here, I'm just going to switch over to the Finder. I'm going to go across here. And so what you can see, the place that I like to put it is, it's kind of an obvious place to me to store it and know that it's safe. I actually put it inside the Adobe Flash Builder 4 folder that's created for you by the Adobe Flash Builder installer when it's installed the application. And it's actually inside your documents folder, so it's the default one that it makes for you. So I just put it in there, and I know it's nice and safe, and there's that swc file that we downloaded. So that's all we need to do with those. So what we'll do now is we'll switch over to Flash Builder 4 and set up a project to start using this 3D engine that we've downloaded. So here we are in Flash Builder 4. I've cleared everything out, so we've got a nice clean slate to work with. And all you need to do now is create a new project. So I'm just gonna click here, and I'm gonna go new, and I'm actually gonna create an ActionScript project, because for a lot of this, really, you're gonna be using ActionScript to create and manipulate the stuff inside the 3D scene that you're gonna create. So I'm just going to create this ActionScript project, and I'm going to call it Papervision 3D example. I'm going to leave everything else the same. It's going to put it inside our Adobe Flash Builder 4 folder under our Papervision 3D example folder, and I'm just going to go next. And now comes one of the really important steps. Let me just make the dialog smaller here and just move it. So what we need to do now is we need to make sure that this project includes a reference to that file that we just downloaded that contains all the nice new Papervision 3D stuff that we need to work with. So I'm just going to click on the Add SWC button here and browse for it. And like I say, let's just move this dialog here. I know that I've put it inside my Adobe Flash Builder 4 folder, inside my Documents folder. And there it is. So I'm just going to click on that and go Open. And go OK. And so that's included. And now I don't really need to change anything else. I'm just going to go finish. And here's our new project. And here you'll notice, we have this referenced libraries one here. Let's just open that up. And so it's now referenced and including that Papervision 3D SWIC file that we downloaded. So that's all we need to do to make sure that when we run this movie, when we debug and build this application, it's going to suck in that SWIC file for the Papervision that we need to use. Now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to cheat a little bit, and I'm going to paste in a little bit of code that I've got that I know will work to just basically allow us to quickly test the scene and make sure that everything's included correctly. So I've just replaced that code with this one here, and the only difference is really, I'm not going to get into the specifics of it, but I think if you're going to be start playing around with this, you're probably familiar with some of this by now, because I'm hopefully you're familiar with some ActionScript at least. You certainly will be by the time you start working with Papervision 3D. So we've included, got a couple of imports here, and then I create a new SWIFT file on the stage with a width and height of 800 for the width, 600 for the height, and I just give it a color for the background. And the only other thing we need to do is I'm extending one of the Papervision classes called Basic View, and I'm essentially just extending it, and I'm going to add a child, which is going to be a new sphere. I'm going to add a sphere to this 3D scene, and then I need to tell it to start rendering. Like I say, I'm not going to go into the specifics of the code on this one. There's probably some future movies that we'll look at for that, and certainly look over the Papervision 3D documentation on the website. But that's all we need to do here, really. And I'm just going to go Command and F11 to debug the application. It's going to load it up in the browser. And it doesn't look like much, but we've gone a long way in this movie. This is actually a 3D scene, this whole black area that you're seeing. And in there is a 3D sphere. So we know that we've downloaded the file. We've included it in a test project, an example project, and it's actually working correctly. So there you go. That's a working 3D Papervision project ready for you to start having some fun with.